You said P Dope, right? So you said you got an entertainment company.
Yeah.
It's something that you started?
Yeah, that's something I started. Yeah.
When you what made you start that?
I mean, I just felt like, you know what I'm saying, like I wanted to be more independent and more in control of what I'm doing and the direction that I'm going in.
Right.
So I got myself, I got my artist Dolo, you know what I'm saying, Dolo BML. We just shot this video last night.
Mm-hmm.
Monastery in Lexington.
So I guess before we even go into that, right, because that's definitely a major part of what you're doing in your career and your success and soon to come success. Before we get into that, let's just talk about your upbringing and where you from. You say you're from Liberty Heights.
Yeah.
Liberty Heights. So how long you was living around Liberty Heights, or you grew up around Liberty Heights?
I mean, I was born right there, you know what I'm saying? I had a wild upbringing, bro. Like,
how was it? Like, it was wild.
Shit was crazy.
Man. I mean, it's Baltimore, so I feel like...
You know what I'm saying? Like, I had a lot of anger issues as a kid, you know what I'm saying? Like, I got put out of school and shit like that. Like, fucking third grade, I got put out of all Baltimore City curriculum shit, you know what I'm saying? So, from there, we just started moving around, just trying to get shit together.
So, did you ever get back into school?
Yeah, I got back in, for
like,
sure.
How far did you go?
I wound up going to college.
For real?
Yeah.
That's lit. What college you go to?
I went to the University of Baltimore.
Oh, that's dope. Yeah, that's a good ass college.
Yeah, you feel me? Nigga, that was been slow.
Yeah.
You feel me? Nigga got anger issues.
You graduated?
Yeah.
That's dope. Congrats, bro.
Yeah, like,
nigga, that's amazing.
Look, they said I wouldn't never be able to do nothing. You know what I'm saying? They put me out of high school, all that shit, bro. I got put out of school about 3-4 times.
Bro, I swear to God, real life, I got put out of 5 different elementary schools.
Yeah.
Deadass. I went to one middle school only because by the time I got to middle school, I was tired of it. Well, I thought I was tired of it.
Yeah.
I got skipped. Like, I got skipped in 6 because I was behind 2 grades. So I went to, like, Twilight School and shit.
Yeah.
Went to high school. I put out of high school. Went to college. I put out of 2 different colleges.
Yeah.
All for fighting.
They give up on niggas so fast.
Yeah. So, like, I get it. When you say, I ain't answer, like, nigga, I just didn't fight.
You're never be able, you know what I'm saying? So, I always use that, like, someone telling me what I can't do.
Right.
Like, that shit motivates me way more
than
somebody congratulating me. You know what
Facts.
I'm saying? Like,
facts.
That's always been, like, my rocket fuel, I guess. You know what I'm saying?
No, that's true. So, like, what made you get into music in the first place then?
I wrote my first song, like, I think I was about 9.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I always was into, like, poetry and spoken word and things like that. And I remember watching Jay-Z, Can't Not the Hustle, you know what I'm saying? I was watching his mannerisms and shit like that. I'm like, yo, this nigga's too slick, like, you feel me?
Right.
So I always kind of modeled myself after him as an artist, you know what I'm saying?
So how long have you been in the music industry, I guess?
Well, I mean, I fell in love with music as a kid. I would say I've been really grinding seriously probably about 4 or 5 years.
Yo, I get jealous of niggas like that. I ain't gonna lie, because, like, not like real jealous, but I be upset because I literally just got into the industry like that. Like, I've been hosting since 2014, doing radio for like 2 years now.
Right.
But so when people talk about these historic albums and artists like Jay-Z, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, I can't remember it because I was too busy playing football.
Yeah.
I was just being a knucklehead for real, so I ain't really listen to music. So it's like, when people bring up the Jay-Z's and Tupac's and Biggie's, I'm like, damn, I wish I could have enjoyed that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that was always my escape, bro. Like, I wasn't never really an athlete or nothing.
Right.
I think I'm 5'6", 5'7". Like, all my homeboys...
Shit, I ain't too much taller.
Yeah,
I'm 5'9".
All my niggas like 6'1", 6'2". I'm like, man, I'm not hooping with y'all niggas, man.
Yeah,
fuck y'all
niggas. Yeah.
I'm being here in this motherfucking studio, you feel me?
But, I mean, that's good that you found something that early, because a lot of niggas, especially where we come from,
yeah,
like, they get into the streets, start selling drugs.
I mean, I was in the street, too.
But I feel like, honestly, I'm going to keep it 100.
Juggling the both.
That's the thing about rap niggas, right?
Yeah.
And, like, I don't mean to generalize niggas, but it is what it is. Niggas rap niggas. But that's the thing about, like, being in the industry so early. I think it kind of pulls you to the streets, though.
Yeah, I mean.
Because, like, you got to, like, a lot of people want to, from my experience, a lot of the rappers, like, they want to rap what they live about. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So, like, that kind of make them do it even more, in a sense.
That's, I think so.
Yeah, so it's like when I was playing football, that was the last thing I wanted to do. Even as drug dealers, like back in my, when I was young, they used to tell me, don't even do it, continue to play football. Right now, if I was a rapper, they probably be like, yeah, bro.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? That's what I feel like.
Yeah. I think it's definitely a lot of pressure on the young niggas, you know what I'm saying, to stunt out and shine, because that's what we looking up to. We looking up to niggas who showing us the end game, but they not showing you the process of how to get there. So niggas just showing you like, boom, I'm in foreigns, my nigga, I'm in, you feel me, I got $30,000 on my neck.
Nigga, got like 25 on my wrist. Yeah. Like,
wow, so nigga sitting there making noodles like, damn, how the fuck? You not showing me the resources I need, you not showing me the path, you just showing me the end game.
Right.
So sometimes, you know what I'm saying, you get sold into the end game, but not necessarily the process.
So how quick did you catch on to that though?
It took me a long time to catch on to that, though. I ain't gonna lie to you. Like, I got older. I had to really learn from fucking up. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't really have any, I ain't really grow up with any mentors. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Same. That might be a Baltimore thing. Like, we really be in the trenches, bro.
Yeah, yeah, you feel me? All the niggas I looked up to you was, you know what I'm saying, on some other shit.
Right.
We was on some other shit, you know what I'm saying?
So, like, what did a particular event occur for you to get it, like, snap in your head, like, all right, I get it, like, I can't keep
I was like, I think I was like 21. I got shot, I was 21. And I just remember laying in the hospital and like, everybody around me like, yo, you was the one.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I thought I was gonna be gone. I'm like, nah, I'm still the one, you feel me?
Right.
So, you know what I'm saying? Once I got out of that situation and dealt with that, you know what I'm saying? I wanted to put full effort behind what I'm doing.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And not so much talking about it or just saying what you could be. Like, I'm going to show you what the fuck I am. You know what I'm saying? Like, and putting my full effort behind that. You know what I'm saying? And when I started doing that, I started seeing a lot of doors open that weren't opening before. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Or, like, sometimes, man, like, I just wake up and I'm just like, listen, man, we're going to do X, Y, Z, and it makes no sense.
Mm-hmm.
Because based on what we have, there's no reason we should be able to do that.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? Based on where we're at, necessarily, there's no reason we should be able to do that, man. That shit click, like, real shit.
You definitely blessed, my nigga, like, just to be able to go through that, have that testimony.
Yeah.
I want to ask, because you got it at 21, but before you got it, you had to go through what you went through.
Yeah.
You might have had to get shot to really understand.
Yeah.
What do we tell our... the ones that's coming up, you know what I'm saying, that's making music and they in the streets and things like that. It's like, you can't really tell them not to be in the street because that's all they know.
Yeah.
But at the same time, it's like, bro, you the talent, like you the ticket in your hood. If anything happened to you, everything goes down. How do you get them to realize that before they can get shot?
Hopefully you don't gotta get shot to see that. But I think it's really a structural situation where the niggas in your hood gotta be understanding as well that we gotta get behind this person.
Right.
Even if it's not rapping, like, fuck everybody wanna be a rapper, fuck all that. Like, if it's a nigga with any type of idea or any type of dream, it's gonna start at its immediate surroundings.
Right.
Because you're looking, you're not gonna be 100% confident in something if you haven't seen it work yet.
Right.
So you're looking around you like, this nigga's gonna fuck with this, this nigga's gonna support this. And sometimes during that process, you can get lost on focusing on the people that aren't supported.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I always
the
tell,
and shit like that.
I tell all my niggas, like, we ain't even gonna focus on the niggas that ain't fucking with it. We gonna feed quality to the niggas that is fucking with it.
I fuck with that.
And what happens eventually is that grows. You see what I'm saying? That grows. It's like cancer. You know what I'm saying? The shit gotta grow.
Exactly.
So even if
Some people are negative and it can grow positive.
Yeah,
a lot of people think cancer itself is only negative. Like,
it
can be a positive thing too.
Yeah, real shit. So it's like, even if one nigga fuck with what you doing, you know what I'm saying? And he tell another nigga. But if you only focus on the 99 niggas who didn't fuck with what you was doing, that shit would have deteriorated you all the way.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
And it's also like a spit in the face to the person that is fucking with you. Like,
yeah, because it's like, nigga, I fuck with
you.
Yeah, like, nobody fuck with me.
You put so much energy into niggas that don't fuck with you. It's like, bro, like, you got niggas, even if it's, like you said, one person, like, my nigga, acknowledge them. Yo, thank you. I really appreciate it.
Yeah.
Like, even with me doing interviews, I tell people all the time, for people that even come out, like, y'all want to get interviewed by Jay Hill, that means something. Like, niggas can go to anybody, boy. Yeah. Like, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, I definitely understand that part.
Yeah, like, you gotta focus on your core audience. You know what I'm saying? Feed them and shit will fall in place. You know what I'm saying?
So now we spoke about how you can wake up and be like, yo, we're gonna do X, Y, and Z. And it might not even make sense.
Yeah.
But do you think part of that, when you was learning, when you was going through what you was going through to learn where you at now, do you think that's the reason that they can trust you? Like, cause you didn't did it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, yo, wake up X, Y, Z, it don't make sense, but yo, you can trust me.
Yeah.
So I feel like, do you think, of course there's a reason for everything, but do you think people gotta go through that just so they can have that trust, or is there another way? Because I know, I just want people to understand, like, the streets ain't the only way, it's other ways you can go about it. So that's what I'm trying to get that message to see. How can somebody trust somebody that ain't go through it, I guess?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I guess the best answer to that would be...
That's a hard question.
It ain't even trusting me.
Yeah.
It's the fact that I trust God.
Okay.
God not gonna let me down. So if you trust in what I'm saying, you gotta be trusting in that. So if you're moving with full faith, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm moving with faith. Like,
facts.
It ain't even about
faith. It ain't my plan, it's God.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? This ain't even me. This me being right here right now, bro, I just drove past four accidents. Literally. Like, it just took me ran a whole nother way.
Mm-hmm.
And I popped up. You know what I'm saying? Like, I didn't even get the email to come here and tee you until 1.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? Like, but it was meant for me to be right here. You see what I'm saying? Like, so, like, you just got to trust the process. Like,
that's true.
But it's so hard. The streets ain't the only way to eat. The streets is what niggas go to because it's easy. You see what I'm saying? It doesn't require any prerequisites. It doesn't require much uncommon knowledge. You know what I'm saying? And that's what niggas attract to. But, you know, it feeds niggas, you know what I'm saying? It pays the bills.
Right.
But I feel like if you're going to be in the streets, you definitely got to have that exit strategy.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, part of being in this game is knowing when to put in and when to cash out. You know what I'm saying? Like, the niggas that don't know when to cash out is all the type of niggas we hear about on American Gangster and all that. You know what I'm saying? Like, niggas doing...
Them niggas end up ratting.
70 years. Yeah, man, listen.
Niggas want to be gangster. Them niggas end up ratting for real, though. Like, Frank Lucas, he snitched, man. So it's like, nah, I get you. But so, let's go back to 21, right? Yeah. I know I don't want to keep living this image, but you definitely blessed, you know what I'm saying? So let's go back to 21.
It is what it is.
Now you see that, yo, I'm not, like you said, I ain't gone. I'm still here. We're going to keep making it. From when you was landing that bed, from what time, from then to up to now, when did you be like, yo, I want to make my own label?
Well, since I was like a teenager, I always wanted to have ownership. Mm-hmm. Like, we always was able to click up and make music, and the creation process was always there, but we didn't necessarily know how to move this music or how to navigate through the industry. You know what I'm saying? Like, I actually lived down the street from Reggie Reg.
Mm-hmm. Reggie Reg.
OG. Used to play football in his backyard and shit like that.
We used to play football with Reggie Reg?
Yeah.
Oh, see, you up there, bro. See,
that was my man.
I'm a young nigga.
Yeah, that was my man, yeah.
Yeah.
So, like, he used to give us tips and things like that and here and there, but at the same time, he wasn't, like, you feel me? Like, we not signed to Reggie Reg. So
right.
Mm-hmm. Whenever he can, he give us advice, but, you know, it's still get it on your own. You know?
So you think he was the one that placed that thought in your mind about, yo, you want to have ownership to your rights?
He gave us the principles of how to move, you know what I'm saying? And not just, oh, I can rap, so niggas owe me the world.
Right.
You see what I'm saying? Like, niggas don't owe you shit. Like, you feel me?
That's fortunate to even be around somebody like that. I only say that because, like, especially during that time, because during that time, all the artists was looking for deals, and we talking about 360 deals around that time.
Yeah.
Because that's their only way out. You know what I'm saying? They ain't understand it. So for you to even be around Reggie Reg and him to explain that to you, that's fortunate in itself.
It's definitely, it was an amazing, looking back on it, you know what I'm saying? It was definitely an amazing situation.
So what age did you, or what year did you create your own label?
We've been on some mob shit for a while. Like, I can't even honestly remember.
That's good.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like,
so y'all been independent before independent was hot? Because this is a thing now.
Yeah, this is... Now it's like, I'm independent. Like, niggas with real situations are independent.
Right. You know, and even, like, in But it's funny because just like before we can get to independent, just this millennial age is about entrepreneurship too.
Yeah.
So like it kind of been a well not been but it's just starting to be a trend. Okay, yeah. Fucking 9 to 5. You know what I'm saying? Even though, don't get it twisted. A real nigga have a 9 to 5 too. But now you see more people like I want to do my own thing.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So I think that rolled over into the people want to be independent.
Yeah.
And it's like
it's definitely because now it's easier to become a brand.
Mm-hmm.
Before it was
social
like,
media.
Yeah, social media. You know. Wasn't what it is right now. So right. Now it's easier to build a following and then, you know what I'm saying, navigate with that following and mobilize that following to do the things you need them to do, whether it's rapping or modeling, whatever the hell it is.
Mm-hmm.
But I would definitely say don't fall a victim of social media.
Mm-hmm.
Because everything you see on social media is not...
Boy,
what like, it is, you know what I'm saying, like,
and that fucks it up too, because like, that's probably one of the core reasons why people are not patient, because they see everybody else shining on Instagram.
Yeah.
Like you said, like when you was coming up, you might see one nigga from the block had it on his watch, but now you see everybody.
Yeah,
now it's like you want to be that.
Yeah,
and it's like you that shit that might be their friends, their homeboys. Yeah. Like,
but it's because you can create. To the people who don't know you, you can create whatever persona it is you're mm-hmm. trying to create.
Right.
The nigga who know you is looking like, man, this nigga got my motherfucking watch on right now. You know
what I'm saying?
Yeah, yo, like, to the young dudes, man, like, don't try to follow what niggas is doing. Like, just trust your process, you know what I'm saying?
Thanks.
Like, build your brand up. Build your shit up. Do the research needed to be successful.
So you think that's your, like, your main core... model or something that you want to push?
Yeah.
Just trust the process. No.
Trust the process.
So the name, because I want to get back into the label. Am I saying it right? It's a label, right?
Yeah, you call it a label.
What's the name of it?
High Society ENT.
High and Society.
Yeah.
Why High Society?
Well, one, I get high a lot.
I'm sorry we have a space for you to do it down, bro.
You know what I'm saying? But no, it's all about an elevated state of mind. You
definitely.
Know what I'm saying? An elevated state of being.
Bro, that what people don't understand is whatever you like to do, bro, you can find some type of positive message behind it.
Yeah.
Like, even, like, you get what I'm saying, how you said, I get high, like, that might be the truth, like, man, fuck it, high society, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But you see how you can also change it, like, everything is about elevation. You know what I'm saying?
It's about
like,
elevation.
People, I wish people could understand that, like, no matter what the root of it is, you can always find a positive flip on it. Like, I fuck with that.
I get high and I come up with creative shit.
I fuck with that.
That's what I did.
Nah, I fuck with that.
Appreciate
I fuck with that. So you talk about your team. You say you got a creative director.
Yeah, I got my creative director. That's my man. That's my partner. You know what I'm saying? My nigga Malcolm, FWTK.
Mm-hmm.
We've been building together for about 3-4 years now. You know what I'm saying? This is going to be our third project working together that's coming up. I don't want to let the cat out the bag on that too heavy.
Nah. You give us some type of exclusive fucking
you know
like something.
It's going to be that.
Nah, I feel
it's going to change sound.
What about the video you shot yesterday, you said?
Oh, yeah, the video we just shot.
That's going to be on that project?
This video is for Dolo.
Okay.
That we just shot, my man Dolo. You know what I'm saying? Shout out Dolo. We're going to get him more here real soon.
Facts.
We just shot that. We shot that around the way, Monastery Lexington. My man, this shit was crazy, yo. My man, this nigga Dolo, we shoot the video. Boom, I'm controlling everything, whatever. I see this nigga walk off. Where the fuck this nigga going?
Out the video? Like,
he's walk off, right? This nigga spin back around the corner with a 40-foot fucking ladder.
What the
You know
fuck?
What I'm saying? Like, yo, this nigga funny as shit. This nigga spin the bin with a 40-foot ladder. We fucking pick the ladder. Take like 4 niggas to pick the ladder up. Shit, like a 700-pound ladder, my nigga.
Right.
Like, you know, everybody all fucked up and shit. Trying to pick up a ladder, my nigga. Like, picture this. Like, we fucked up.
Mm-hmm.
It's a 700 fucking pound ladder. This nigga came out the corner with it. Like,
right.
You know what I'm saying? This nigga climb up, hop on top of the corner store, top of the shit. I'm like, oh, this nigga funny as shit, man.
And I always ask people, like, when we, like, sum it up, what's the purpose of you even coming to, like, a influencer like J Hill for this interview? Like, what's your purpose?
My purpose is to have more people understand what I'm about to do. You know what I'm saying? Like, I think a lot of people are sleeping. Man, we're about to bring something extremely powerful. You know what I'm saying? Because to me, what we're doing is deeper than music.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't just do music. like I rap or whatever, I write songs. That's cool. A lot of people know me for that. But we also do fashion.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Like I have my clothing line is in a couple stores around Baltimore.
What's the name of
Pittsburgh. We haven't quite given it a name. We just kept it under High Society. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
Because we're not necessarily doing one thing, like let's say how Ralph Lauren Polo would be.
Right.
We're more so just giving you merchandise. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So we're giving you a variety of t-shirts, varieties of hoodies, varieties of like joggers, different things.
So what stores
we're creating
in the city?
Like if I the main store is Angel Park. Angel Park Boutique is down, I believe it's Lishiana Street.
Like what part of town is it?
That's shit, I'm drawing a blank right now.
Yeah, I'm about to say you got a cop son.
It's on Lishiana Street.
Okay.
That's down by the fucking water. You know what I'm saying?
Fuck it. The harbor.
Yeah.
Fellows Point.
Fellows Point.
All right, good, good.
Fellows Point.
Shout out to Avery, the man behind the camera.
Yeah. I told you I get high, bro. Like,
it's all good.
Every interview I do.
How the hell you know that?
Every interview I do, I go blank for a second. Like, nigga, I got to chill.
It's all good.
But look, it's down there. You know what I'm saying? Shout out my nigga down there, my nigga Jay at Angel Park. They got a lot of exclusive stuff that's on fire right now. You know what I'm saying?
And is there anything else you want people to know?
Our next thing we're going to do, we plan on kind of leaning more into the artistic side of things.
Like what, though?
Creative director. We're about to put together a small art exhibit.
That's lit, bro. That's different.
Yeah.
I'm fucking with the movement. Like, y'all might have signed me, you feel me? Like, I'm fucking with the movement.
We got room, you know what I'm saying? It's going to be a hip-hop art combination exhibit, you know what I'm saying?
Y'all got a date for that?
We don't have a date yet, but it's coming. We're putting it in the works right now.
I'm definitely looking forward to it, bro. Like, yeah. I fuck with it, bro. I appreciate you coming up.